81 degrees. Oh. I'm getting ready to go tour the second day of the season. As you can see, it is just bluebird. Alright, so here on top of the path again. Love it up here. We got the ghost trees going on. It's pretty sweet. I'm touring today with the Travis Wright split. Kind of watch it go through the pal a little bit here. We got some filmer bros over here. Let's go see what they're up to. So I told those kids that they're in the middle of a big avalanche path building their booter, and I asked them if they had any avi gear or beacons, and they said not on them, I guess maybe in their backpacks. So yeah, that sucks. But anyway, look at the snow. Killer. As you can see, it's super wind loaded. See what I'm about to get to ride? Yeah, buddy. I'm still stoked on that last run, even though it's very short. It's really cold again, as I've said today, so I'm going to stay in the sun. That's my plan. Oh, you can't see Edelweiss is behind that tree. I wanted to go ski that pole over there, but most of it would put me in the shade touring up, and that did not sound like fun today. I'm kind of wimpy when it comes to the cold. But yeah, go get another lap. This time I'm going to go over, even further. Psyched. Anyway, Lip Tech, Travis Rice, testing out this Tetons pack as well. It's the Blade 38. Even though it's cold out, really cold, you really want to make sure you hydrate when you're out in the mountains too, which is really tough in the winter. You know, if I was out mountain biking or hiking, I'd be drinking water, but I haven't drank any water yet, and I've been out for about 2 hours now, so. To carry platypus with me. I first heard about platypus from my friend Porchy, who's a guide up in Haines. This thing's really cool. As you can see, it's flexible, so it kind of goes anywhere. And it has not froze yet. I don't believe I've had this freeze on me. Camelbacks will freeze. Nalgene's will freeze, all that shit. But platypus seems to be doing really good. So definitely, give yourself a drink. To rip this backcountry run. Look at that. Wow. How much did this cost you to get up here?
$0.
Wow. Epic.
Hey, I'm Howie. It's good to meet you.
Howie, Mike. Nice to meet you as well. Oh, I'm so stoked to watch you ski this. Oh my gosh. Ladies and gentlemen, Howie. Oh, look at that. He claiming it. Howie Geezer rips it. Yee-hoo. Yeah. I just saw Howie rip that run. That was so good. Now I get to get my little secret run in.
Oh, the Tetons are delivering.
Touring out, now I'm in the shade. have to come back up, get those sooner. Luckily, my Coltex skins, I can't really see them. They're kind of coming off, but they held on the way up. And there's a lot of people struggling right now, putting boot pack up the skin track. When it's this cold, a lot of times skins just don't want to work. Most things don't really want to work when it's below freezing temperatures. And that makes day two in the books. As you can see, this snow, it's glistening, nice and beautiful, but not going to be so great when the next storm comes. Looks nice and crystally. The only hiccup with that is, and I believe Lynn Wolf is the one that said this, local avalanche legendary teacher, instructor, and today's surface is tomorrow's problem. So what this is a surface hoar that's growing. It was really cold last night, probably down to negative 20 Fahrenheit, and because of this, we're going to be, the next snowfall that comes is going to be sitting on top of this, which is already sitting on something similar. So just be mindful. Pay attention as you're going up the mountain.